All 50 American states are abundant in ice cream shops. But with everyone screaming for ice cream, it can be hard to know where to go to satisfy your cravings. But based on tons of online evidence, we've compiled a list of the best ice cream shops in every state. Cammie's Old Dutch ice cream shop has such a good product that one reviewer who's, quote, not even a huge fan of ice cream, visited the shop 3 times in 8 days. Fabled rotating flavors include prickly pear, Crayole praline, and red velvet. No matter what you choose there, though, you know it's going to be good. Wild Scoops is no average ice cream shop. Made in small batches and using locally sourced ingredients, flavors change as radically as the seasons and include the utterly Alaskan fireweed, spruce tip, and Sitka swirl. Perhaps wildest of all is the Baked Alaska, a waffle cone topped with torched marshmallow cream. Asked by the Phoenix Business Journal what title she'd give to her autobiography, Sweet Republic's co-founder replied, "Life is like 100 flavors of ice cream. Don't always pick vanilla." The answer is fitting for this Scottsdale-based favorite, which artisanally elevates classics like Belgian chocolate and real mint chip, while coaxing Arizonans to try something unusual with flavors like black sesame. Not to mention the Toffee Banoffee Sundae that famously bewitched Alton Brown. Named after the state tree, Loblolly ice creams gloriously fuse tried, true, and traditional with outrageously inventive. Aside from deliciousness, the common denominator is hyperlocality. Arkansan artisans, farms, and gardens provide ingredients and inspiration, while everything from the marshmallows in the Little Rocky Road to gluten-free or vegan cones is made in-house. In this country-sized state, rich in creativity and foodie fads, it's excruciatingly painful to choose just one best ice cream shop. However, once the pain subsides, there's abundant joy in the San Fran Creamery, whose mantra is "scooping happiness every single day." Byright does so by using organic 88 dairy, the butterfat content of which is off the charts. In Denver, the original Little Man ice cream shop is housed within a giant 28-foot-tall milk can, and its recently completed Willy Wonka-esque factory and tasting room, accessed through a walk-in freezer, is designed to replicate an industrial ice cream churn. And yet, the inevitable lines are less about photo ops than signature flavors such as salted Oreo and 16th Street chocolate, scooped into crispy homemade waffle cones and sprinkled with textured toppings. Ferris Acres is the Newtown Creamery where Connecticut natives will send you to savor the likes of Cowabunga Crunch and Mocha Mayhem in the company of grazing cows. 3 generations of the Ferris family are involved in making the on-site ice cream, as well as sorbets and ice cream pies. Seasonal offerings are particularly comforting, with caramel apple pie announcing the arrival of fall and eggnog providing cheer in the depths of winter. Recognized as one of the oldest remaining farms in America's first state, Woodside Farm is perhaps even more celebrated for its scoops. Woodside's ice cream relies on the fresh milk of its Jersey cows, milked nightly by descendants of the Mitchells who founded the dairy farm in 1796. The freshness of the ingredients is impressive, but so are historically winning flavor combinations such as chocolate peanut butter, black raspberry chip, and butter brickle. Established in 1956, Jackson's Ice Cream Parlor and Restaurant is a family-owned institution that's all about epicness. Proof positive, their vast collection of American memorabilia, the run-on menus, and the heaping portions of homemade ice cream. The downright monumental sundaes culminate in the kitchen sink. A minimum of 4 gluttons is recommended to attack the pound-per-person scoops of ice cream heaped with toppings, lit up with a sparkler, and served in an actual kitchen sink. When Morelli's husband and wife founders traded a livelihood in pharmaceutical sales for a love of ice cream making, they had no idea that within a year, their Atlanta parlor would be named the 4th best ice cream shop in America by Bon Appetit. Morelli's flavors tap into various cravings, including childhood nostalgia, refined sophistication, and southern comfort. The most popular flavor, original salted caramel, is also the most heavily guarded. Hawaii might be famed for its macadamia nuts, but it's also one of the only American states that commercially produces its own coffee. In addition to popular flavors such as Kona Coffee, Macadamia Nut, and Kauai Pie, state best ice cream shop Lappert's serves affogatos in which ice cream gets a proper drowning in a double shot of espresso, erupting in molten sauces. Sundaes such as the Ka'au Crater Hot Fudge Bomb are downright volcanic. As an acronym, STILL stands for the sweetest things in life. As Boise's most creative creamery bar, the STILL has earned fame and 5-star reviews for unusually creamy ice cream and unusually creative flavors such as Easy Like Sunday Morning and Sweater Weather. Perhaps most unusual is the menu of boozy flavors for the Over 21 set. Founded in 1921, Margie's Candies is a Chicago institution that still serves up vintage ice cream sodas, splits, and floats made at its marble soda fountain. However, pride of place goes to the dependably decadent ice cream sundaes. The classic scoops are awash in Lake Michigan-worthy pools of homemade hot fudge and/or caramel sauce, and served in a signature white clamshell dish. BRIC stands for Broad Ripple Ice Cream Station. If this acronym still doesn't make sense, know that it's all about an ice cream shop, located in Indianapolis's historic railway station. Since it was first referred to as Broad Ripple Station, the original store is a fitting place to savor the creamy, hand-dipped likes of amaretto cherry, rippled with thick fudge, and chocolate rippled with peanut butter, served in waffle cones. Snooky's is a mom-and-pop-style roadside favorite in Des Moines that's been dishing out frosty treats since 1986. Aside from Arctic Blasts, shakes, slushes, and the famous namesake malts, it's the signature soft serve, dipped and/or topped with everything from animal crackers to sour worms, that has fans literally camped out before opening day. They say you can inhale the fragrance of freshly baked waffle cones before even setting foot inside Lawrence's favorite ice cream shop. The devotion to this store seemingly stems from Silas and Maddie's institutional extravagance. For example, when they make watermelon sherbet, an entire watermelon gets tossed into the ice cream machine. Ditto for the pie-based flavors, cherry cobbler, key lime, banana cream, each batch receiving a whole highly recommended pie. The wife and husband duo behind Crink and Boom started making ice cream out of a Cuisinart for their Thai restaurant in Lexington. When they realized that many customers came in just for a scoop, they got wise and opened an ice cream lounge in the historic Distillery District. All ingredients are locally sourced, then cranked into Boom in-your-face signature flavors such as bourbon and honey and Kentucky blackberry and buttermilk. Universal acclaim for the Creole Creamery means you don't have to sweat the decision as to where to satisfy your dairy cravings in the Big Easy. The decor is as retro as fountain shop classics, including floats, splits, and sundaes. But the flavors are decidedly vanguard. Pear and balsamic caramel, white chocolate truffled popcorn, grapefruit and Campari. Rococo is operated by a 10th-generation Mainer who learned all about artisanal ice cream at the other end of the world. The much-lauded results of such lessons are ice cream with strikingly dense textures and distilled flavors. In theory, this sounds great, but the sheer number and inventiveness of the flavors make decisions excruciatingly difficult. Ice cream is a pretty big deal in Maryland, which actually has its own ice cream trail. A non-negotiable stop on that trail is Baltimore's The Charmery, whose owners make creative use of thoughtfully sourced ingredients and dairy from hormone-free happy cows. Although they maintain a handful of always flavors, such as the ultra-chocolatey Maryland Mud, there's a lot of fun to be had with whimsical and seasonal inventions such as baklava, Old Bay Caramel, and cheese and crackers. Toscanini started life as an early 80s communal dream when a bunch of Cambridge pals set out to make and sell ice cream. Toski's quickly became a beloved student hangout, but once the New York Times declared it the world's best ice cream, there was no churning back. You can satisfy homeland hankerings with flavors like B3 and burnt caramel. When ice cream's on the table, people from Michigan believe in heading to the source, which in the case of Moomer's is a dairy farm. Tables overlooking mooing cows are ideal for savoring freshly churned scoops served in cones, cups, flights, sandwiches, and sundaes. With over 160 flavors, decision-making can be rough, but they've got a 10-scoop option on the menu. The Twin Cities is home to dozens of ice cream shops, which might be surprising for a place where the temperature hardly breaks freezing for at least 7 months out of the year. But Barb Zabzalka has been personally making the ice cream at Pump House Creamery in Minneapolis since 2003, turning out exciting and seasonal flavors in small batches 7 days a week, all year long. Pump House Creamery sources the organic dairy and produce from local farms for a hyper-local ice cream experience. The flavors range from the approachable, like Madagascar vanilla and chocolate, to the exploratory, including black garlic with chocolate chips and lemon-infused olive oil and sea salt. Visitors should have no problem finding the perfect scoop, as there are usually 20 flavors on the menu, which include non-dairy ice cream and sorbet options. This compact ice cream shop tucked away in a strip mall shares no obvious similarities to its alien-infested namesake, Area 51. However, taking a bite out of any of the small-batch handmade flavors on offer is commonly described as an out-of-this-world experience. Flavors arrive and vanish without warning due to a reliance on whatever's fresh at the Hernando Farmers Market. But repeat visitors include Saigon Cinnamon Snickerdoodle, Lemon Icebox, and Blackberry Goat Cheese. Given ice cream's historical prominence, it's fitting that Ted Drew's, which started life in the early 1930s as a frozen custard stand, is still king of the scoop according to locals. Although the ice cream sandwiches, sundaes, and absurd number of toppings earn rave reviews, it's the concrete that put Ted Drew's on the map.
Don't they do a thing, because I've been there,
they hold
they
it
turn
up.
It over and then it doesn't come out?
That ain't going anywhere.
Yeah, it's called the concrete, I think.
The lineups to Big Dipper Ice Cream Shop are as long as the compliments it's received over the years for its tasty homemade scoops. Unpretentious, unadulterated, but never underrated permanent flavors include Mexican chocolate, white mint Oreo, and black licorice, with a special shout-out for Huckleberry. Ice cream lovers are wild about this farm-to-cone creamery, where everything you can sink your teeth into is fresh, high-quality, and locally sourced. The scoops menu changes according to the seasons, with flavors catering to both classicists and experimentalists. And Coneflower doesn't skimp on the extras. All the waffle cones, mix-ins, sauces, and toppings are made on-site by an in-house pastry chef. The Steve of Steve's Homemade Ice Cream mastered the art of ice cream making as a teenager, working weekends at a 1930s Staten Island soda shop. Later, he followed his parents to Nevada, setting up Fernley's first ice cream parlor. According to Yelp, countless Nevadans eagerly drive miles through the desert for refreshment that comes from constantly changing flavors. Headquartered in Portsmouth, Annabelle's Natural Ice Cream stays true to the word natural that graces its signage. All its ice creams are made with fresh cream and cane sugar, without an artificial color in sight. If Annabelle's scoops seem thicker, richer, and creamier than the norm, churn it up to the generous levels of butter fat. Revolutionary acts are the day-to-day norm at Princeton's Bent Spoon, where many of the 550 rotating ice creams and sorbets depend on the flavors of the season grown by local farmers and the experimentalism of the founders. Local clients have come to anticipate Sun Gold Saffron Sorbet in summer and shiitake mushroom ice cream in the fall. Santa Fe chef Joel Coleman learned to appreciate things cool and creamy from running the local gastropub Fire and Hops. Coleman routinely trolls the Santa Fe Farmers Market in search of fresh, all-natural ingredients for La Lecheria's refreshing ice cream flavors such as citrus basil, coconut miso, and sweet corn. That said, heat and spice are also a part of the proceedings. New Yorkers are justifiably passionate about everything from baseball to pizza, so why should ice cream be any different? According to top NYC chef Matthew Hyland, what sets Oddfellow's ice cream apart is the texture, a peerless creaminess that transforms potentially bland vanilla. The store's creator also excels at creating unorthodox flavors, such as black pepper fig and miso cherry. Everything about Surf and Spoon Frozen Yogurt Bar is chill. The beachy location, the interior, and the mellow owners, not to mention the froyo itself. Several seasonal flavors are on tap at any time in low and no-fat versions, waiting to be topped off at the bar with everything from fresh fruit to cheesecake bites. There are also vegan soft serve, gelato, sorbet, and heavenly ice cream sandwiches and flavors such as lemon lavberry and Killa Key Lime. North Dakota's last small-town creamery, Pride Dairy, has gallons of historical cred. Dependable flavors such as Thomas Jefferson Vintage Vanilla, Rhubarb Strawberry, Butter Brickle, and Juneberry still earn tons of praise. If you're ever hanging out in North Dakota, it's definitely worth a stop. It's one thing to serve completely sustainable ice cream and quite another to make it completely delicious. Cleveland-based Mitchell's pulls off both feats with natural organic flair from its solar-paneled, skylit, rainwater-harvested headquarters in a renovated silent movie theater. Watch the pros at work integrating quality produce from local farmers and fair trade global partners before sampling flavors such as Bing Cherry Chocolate Chunk, Wild Berry Crumble, and the brilliant Blue Cosmo. Roxy started off as an ice cream truck, named after the husband and wife owner's beloved Great Dane. Customers go particularly nuts over no-nonsense flavors such as subtly sweet pistachio and crunchy pecan. S'more sundaes, dreamsicle floats, and the Cookie Monster sandwich have also become local ice cream lovers' best friends. If you think buttermilk pancakes, bacon, and eggs ice cream sounds like the epitome of stunt food, think again. It's merely one of the seemingly outlandish but seriously delicious flavors that have made Portland-based Salt and Straw one of the best cult ice cream makers in America. With everyone from award-winning chefs to Portland elementary school kids in on the creative process, the flavor possibilities are endless. Best scoop competitions are notoriously tight in a state known for its ice cream trail, ice cream university courses, and over 5,700 dairy farms. So when Fox Meadows ranks number one on the list of 26 top creameries, it's time to head there for an appetizing cow-to-cone experience. Down on the farm, rural flavors dominate, with creative twists that result in lemon crunch, pumpkin creme brulee, and brown butter almond. Providence's favorite frosty treats began life being hawked from a traveling tricycle cart, which is where tricycle ice cream got its name. Although the small batch ice cream is terrific on its own, it gets even better when sandwiched between two cookies or in a dessert taco. Appetizing examples include chocolate ice cream sandwiched between salty pretzel cookies and a peanut butter ice cream taco topped with Oreos. The first thing you need to know about Columbia Sweet Cream Company is that no toppings are allowed, the better with which to highlight the shop's natural flavors. And these aren't just any natural ice cream flavors. Sweet Cream shoves together cherry coke and lemon poppy seed, as well as orange peel with panna cotta. The Black Hills town of Spearfish attracts adventurers year-round. While some come to hike and bike, and others to rock climb or snowshoe, few can resist venturing into family-owned Lyons Creamery, housed within the historic City Hall building. Lyons re-edits the classics while challenging customers to explore off-the-beaten-track flavors such as peanut butter curry and blueberry goat's cheese. Merely reading the daily flavors list at Nashville's award-winning Pied Piper Creamery is more fun than many ice cream experiences, and the scoops themselves are more outrageously creative than their names imply. The one called Trailer Trash is an almost obscene mix of vanilla with Oreos, Twix, Butterfingers, Reese's Pieces, Nestle Crunch, Snickers, and M&Ms, which is nonetheless deemed sublime. There's nothing fake about the name of Austin's Lick Honest Ice Creams. The founders, both from rural areas, take the authenticity of their locally sourced natural ingredients seriously. Regular flavors include dark chocolate, olive oil and sea salt, roasted beets and fresh mint, and Texas sheet cake. For decades, Utah's Brigham Young and Utah State Universities have been rivals about ice cream as well as football. But even alumni admit that upstart Rockwell's super premium, slow-churned ice creams are the best in the state. Locals love regulars such as Rockwell Road, Brown Butter Pecan, and Honeycomb. But national acclaim came with the GOAT, named the best ice cream in America in 2019. Even though it's gone global, Ben & Jerry's heart, soul, and roots are unabashedly Vermont. Way back in the early 1980s, the ice cream pioneer radically altered the ice cream experience by mixing meteorite-sized chunks of everything including brownies, cookie dough, and fish-shaped fudge into its rich scoops. While you can get iconic flavors such as Cherry Garcia, Mint Chocolate Cookie, and Chunky Monkey everywhere from Aruba to the United Arab Emirates, the best place on the planet to savor them is at B&J's Burlington Scoop Shop. Since 1975, no one has been able to tear hungry customers away from the scrumptious small-batch ice cream scoops handcrafted at the Island Creamery. Fitting for an island outpost, the most popular flavors conjure up the carefree pleasures of a beach holiday: marsh mud, bourbon caramel crunch, and pony tracks, a PB&N fudge extravaganza named in honor of the island's second-biggest attraction. At Molly Moon's, the localer, the better. Supposedly, the farthest away they'll go for fruit is Napa Valley. There's a lot of love for the 10 Always flavors, such as Cold Brew Coffee and Scout Mint. Seasonal flavors rely upon Northwestern Bounty, like Vegan Sweet Mint or Lemon Blueberry Custard, and are eagerly awaited. A Charleston favorite since 1997, Ellen's Ice Cream, Sherbets, Gelatos, and Sorbets have won a heaping dose of state and national acclaim over the years. Flavors like Pink Panther will bring you a symphony of raspberry and orange. J.Q. Dickinson Salted Caramel is made with hand-harvested sea salt deposited beneath the Appalachians by an ancient ocean. Following its 1950 inauguration, it was only a decade before cops felt omnipotent enough to branch out beyond the custard realm's two standard flavors by creating the flavor of the day. Decades later, these rotating daily flavors have ventured into deliciously adventurous terrain. Bavarian wedding cake, German apple strudel, and the always anticipated cashew caramel are just a few possibilities, available straight up, shaken up, or as a sundae. Moo's gets rave reviews from the foodie press as Wyoming's best scoop, and it's easy to see why. The Jackson Hole Parlor uses all organic cream in its rich ice creams, which makes them taste creamy and delicious. All this organic goodness and a healthy dose of natural ingenuity results in singular flavors such as Cashew Brittle Crunch, Prickly Pear, and Zonker Stout. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more mashed videos about ice cream are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.